Welcome to the 2019 Winter Universiade and to day one of competition in cross-country skiing. We are at the Radiga Cluster, which is only some 15 minutes drive away from the CBD of Krasnoyarsk in Siberia. And, from wherever you are joining us, a big hello and a big welcome. A truly international field, 24 nations represented in a field of 68. And they'll be skiing in the traditional classic style today, in the women's 5K and then the men's 10K events. Due to the conditions, it's really quite mild for this time of year. Locals telling us that in early March it's normally a bit chillier than this. Only a few weeks ago it was minus 35, but reasonably still 2.1 metres per second the wind today, and it will be Jingyi who leads it away for China. And they go in 30-second intervals. I'm sure you've probably seen your share of cross-country skiing. If you have not, we'll do our best to talk you through what happens in this event. But 30-second intervals, and basically the quickest time wins the day. But here we go. Underway in the women's 5K individual. Classic style. And we wish Jing the best as she sets off. She's from Jilin Jiangsu University. What an opportunity. Not such a great journey for the athletes from China to come across to Siberia. Out of Cornell University is Isabel Sharp. She's 22 years of age. Her ambition will be to, in the first instance, try and catch Zijing. Expect to see quite a range in ability and competitive experience amongst these athletes. See already that Isabel Sharp has overtaken Zijing through the first 1,100 metres. So a promising beginning from Sharp. Appreciate these racing conditions. This first day of competition, well, serious competition, at least after the opening ceremony. There have been some team sports with early matches. One there is Veronika Kaleta, Poland. Lilinpera of Finland. Well, here's athlete to watch with a quick time through the 1.1k checkpoint. Out on the course, Isabel Sharp. Coming up to the second checkpoint. And through in 7 minutes 20. So the first through there. The sound of the skis gliding across the snow here. Even by the sound, you can get a sense of the conditions here. It is below freezing, but milder than it has been. Yes, only a few weeks ago, minus 30 plus 43 on the blue course, the second 2.5 kilometres. So it looks a bit deceptive there. They look like a downhill section, but not really. I'm still having to work hard through this sector. 6, 2, and 4 there, so Blochon, Sharp, and Malkots, France, United States, and Turkey, working their way around the course for the first time. Very excited, a lot of these athletes, to be here today. Kazui Tazukawa, from Waseda University in Japan. And we're getting to them now. As we look at Kristina Kuskova of the Russian Federation, and a mighty cheer goes up for the first of the Russian athletes. And there's a few of them to come too. And now it's Martina Bellini, University of Bergamo. Away she goes. Not wasting any time, looking to get out of the stadium and out on the course. Flush on. Coming down towards the finish. The first of our finishers today. The French competitor comes across the line in 16.7.3 is her semi-official time. Athletes have finished so far. 16.07, the time to beat a Flochon. Sun doing its best to poke through the light cloud cover at Radiger. 44 there is Klementova. Slovakia from the Mete Bell University in Banská Bystrica. And Katri Lilimpera, University of Tampere of Finland. So keep an eye on Lilimpera. She makes her way around the course. She looks like she could be a challenger for best time, but we've still got athletes to leave the start gate, including the highly fancied competitors from the host nation. So really standing by for the way this has been drawn is that we've got the Russian athletes going last, and the crowd can get excited about their performances as they see the clock and the competition. So Lilimpera comes through in a quicker time than Coletta, so she is really motoring well this morning through the 1.9k checkpoint. 12 seconds quicker than Coletta. 45. Lilimpera will be second to finish in this lot. Just see if she can beat the time of Chan Long. She's going to do it by quite a bit. So Lilimpera at 15.07.9 has taken 46 seconds off the previous best time. So well done to the Finn, and she becomes the one to catch at 15.07.8. Polina Nekrasova, National State University of Physical Education. And again, the Russian voices can be heard around the stadium. Nervous moments now for Tatiana Aleshina. Tumen State University. Five of the last six athletes to go are from the Russian Federation. Oh, just struggling with that first bend. Maybe attacked it a bit too hard and fortunately stayed upright. Pushkova, well, outside that time of Lilimpera of Finland. So, Alishina. Here we go, she's going to eclipse the time of Lilimpera by 2.8 seconds. So, a very good opening kilometer from Alishina. Katerina Smeneva, Penza State University. Got a very strong representation at the tail of the field here, where the conditions have been well assessed by their technicians, considering a fair bit of traffic has gone around the course ahead of them. A couple of big screens for the audience to enjoy the progress out on the course, and they'll be keeping an eye on updates bottom of the screen. As you see them, they can see them here in the stadium. The Krasheva just outside that first 1,100-metre checkpoint. Time set by Lelinpera of Finland. Jana Kirpichenko. The Volga Region State Academy of Physical Physical Culture, Sport and Tourism. Kirpichenko, the penultimate athlete in this 5K classic. 65 is Smanova. Won't be far behind Elishina's time at that opening checkpoint. Five seconds down. So still to come through. Now our final competitor, Elisa Sambalova, sets off, and there we have it. The field all out on the course, or some indeed have already finished this big field of 68. Now, opening race of the cross-country program, Krasnoyarsk 2019, and Sambalova is away. That is Sambalova just stepping across to the inside tracks, which of course cuts off just that little bit of territory for a bend. Athletes are very well aware and well trained in taking the optimal route around the course. Di Francesco goes through, but it's Kirpichenko keeping an eye on now as she comes up to crest the rise. Alishina's time is going to stand up. Kirpichenko is 5.5 seconds down there through the first kilometre, so she's got a bit of work to do, providing Alishina can keep up that fine opening pace. Sambalova, last to come through. Shoulders nice and steady and level. Good rhythm. But again, she won't be as quick as Alishina. I don't think the crowd will mind as long as there's a Russian athlete top of the frame, and it's Alishina at the moment, as Sambalova is almost 10 seconds down on Alishina. So let's see what she has in the tank. Slower athletes and get a momentary lapse of concentration. Step onto the wrong turn, wrong course, and your race is done. It's very hard to come back from that kind of mistake. So, Smanova is 65. Down into the tuck position, just looking to get back some oxygen into the lungs. Allows them to push on the uphill sections, and then front and back of the ski is the glide wax that they use in the flatter and downhill sections. Listen to the hard work going in. Smirnova in 65 coming up. Now 67, Kirpichenko, also of the Russian Federation. Sun coming through more strongly now. Just a beautiful morning in Krasnoyarsk for this first day of cross-country competition. We're going to have the men's 10K to follow the women's 5K. An even bigger field for the men. So exciting racing here on the first day. And who will it be in the first race? The Russian team setting out after this time set by Katri Lilinpera of Finland. 1507.8 to beat. 67 there is Kirpichenko. A little bit of slip underneath on the uphill section. She stepped away from the tracks, now back in. Sambalova just looking at the times through the halfway point, Alishina, Smirnova and Kopechenko were all quicker than the Finn Lilian Perra. So halfway stage of the race, Russia 1-2-3. And then Lilian Perra and Zambalova. So Russia, five of the top six quickest times through the first half of the course. Franchi coming down to see if she can beat the time of Lilian Perra. So the Italian is the new leader.
6 секунд улучшение результата театра Лилиан Перра. И все, пожалуй, можно забыть о всевозможных промежуточных.
By some 6 seconds, so a good race.
На отметке 3.5. Алиса
Франки, but it's not going to be long now until this squad of Russian athletes come swooping into the start-finish area, and there'll be a big cheer for them if they can beat this time of 15:01.8 now. So it's really looking good for a golden start to the cross-country competition for the host nation. 67 there is Kopechenko. 2.7 to the good of Smirnova through the 4.2-kilometre checkpoint. So 800 metres to go for Kopechenko to perhaps take the prize, or will it be Alishina? And she's not going to do it. She started so well, but maybe spent a bit too much energy in the opening 2 kilometres. So Alishina, 12 seconds behind Franki. And Smirnova has clipped 9.5 seconds off the time of Franki, so she has finished brilliantly. So Smirnova, it wasn't as quick as Alishina in the opening 1,500 metres or so, has swept home. And we've got Kopechenko coming into the start-finish area. 14:52 to beat. We've got Russia, Italy and Finland 1-2-3 at the moment. Only a couple still out there. Zambalova also waiting for her. And Kopechenko coming down to the line. And she's just got to get there in a hurry. 14:52 to beat, and she's done it. No, she hasn't. Oh, 0.1 of a second outside Smirnova. Oh, a tenth of a second. Well, at first look, it seemed like she had it. And still coming down to the line, Zambalova, and Zambalova's going to steal it. She has, by 3.7 seconds. And the last athlete out on the course is the one with the best time. This is Alisa Zambalova from Buryat State University.
The Euro leader of the gonki, Alisa Zambalova. Второй результат у Екатерины Смирновой.
Those lungs are absolutely burning. But the pain is worth the prize. Zambalova has done the job today in the 5K.
Даже сложно было себе представить, что они окажутся на
старте. Zambalova's time 14:48.
Разницей в 1/10 секунды.
3.7 seconds ahead of Smirnova.
Ну а лидер Алиса Зембалова подтвердила тот факт.
Well, what a thrill for the Russian crowd here. They've actually got the 1-2-3. So it's Zambalova, Smirnova, and Kopechenko. Gold, silver, and bronze. 1-2-3. And what great fun for the fans here in Krasnoyarsk. Unofficial results at this stage. It's Russia 1-2-3. Zambalova from Smirnova and Kopechenko. There we have it on your screens now from the Italian, Francesca Franki. Katri Lilian Perra of Finland had the lead time for quite a while until the Russian contingent changed the look of the leaderboard. Nekrasheva and Alishina, 6th and 7th, and Litocha of Poland in the top 8 there, 38 seconds behind Zambalova. Japan, Finland, Switzerland, Kazakhstan, Austria, all in the next 8. So well done to Takizawa, the leading Japanese finisher, 46 seconds off the pace. Teammate Yokohama not far behind. Let's work our way through the field for you. Chanlong of Thailand, great race from her. It's the minute and 6 seconds behind the leader. Abdehalden of Switzerland in 24th position. Floshon, one of the early starters and temporarily had the lead, ended up a minute 18 behind Zambalova. Slovenia's Neža Zerjav in 39th position. Paul of Australia, 2:23 behind. Camille Ham of Canada, a Mongolian athlete there. Arian Sanar and Dalamun Seren. Zhao of China in 64th position. And there we have it, the 67 in the field. So a great joy for the athletes to be presented with their medals so soon after their event. This is the women's 5K medal presentation. Yana Kopachenko from the Volga region. Bronze medal. Ekaterina Smirnova. Ekaterina Smirnova. Just getting that silver medal by a tenth of a second from her teammate Kopachenko.
The gold medalist of the 29th Winter University Krasnoyarsk 2019,
representing the Russian Federation, Alisa Zhambalova.
Alisa Zhambalova leaps to the central position on the podium. A winner in this opening event by 3.7 seconds, the 5K Classic. Beautiful looking medals.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the Sioux Anthem.
Rounds off a very exciting and successful day. Hope you've enjoyed the competition, and there's plenty more to come at the Krasnoyarsk Universiade.